Have you ever wondered what links are and how do you make them? Well, we're going to look at that in this video. As you can see, this one has a few different links already set up. One of them that's very popular is LinkedIn search, and we can take a look at that, but we'll go ahead and add one to show you the steps. So you can either go from here to add a link, or the other way that you can go is starting from the home page, go to settings under modules and fields, click on which module you want and links and buttons, and you can add a new link. So either way works, either way is efficient. And this is how we're going to go. So for this, the label is the name that you want. Make it descriptive. This one is going to be Twitter lookup. And I have already copied this in. And so we want, there should be, you can start to look for their Twitter ID. This is a field that is in there, and save it. And look, now it's there. So quick little caveat though, is for any like LinkedIn, Google Contacts, Twitter, you have to already be logged in on your browser window. So you don't have to have it open, don't have to have the tab open, but you have to be logged in so that way it will work. So now if I do a Twitter lookup, which you can see on this one, the handle is there. And if I do click it, it opens a new window and takes me to that contact, which happens to be myself in this case. It took me right to their profile so that I can see it. The same with LinkedIn. What it's going to do is it's actually going to take the name, and we can go look at that real quick. I can show you. So here's one, and it's already here. So if we edit it, you can see here's the URL that's built. Typically, what you're going to do, a lot of times you can go to the page LinkedIn and be able to find this information, or do a Google search to be able to get you up to this point. And then you filled in, as you saw, I filled these in using this. And so that is how I do. And this is how it then works. When I click on it, it's going to look for the name, and it has found myself. We use this quite a bit when we're working with clients to be able to get more detail on them. And so we have a better understanding. And a lot of people like using them. A lot of people like using Google Maps. You can use different ones. There's all kinds of things. The limit is you can only have 10 per module, and 10 links total per module. Now, you will see that there are some modules that don't allow for it, and how you can tell whether it allows for it or not. Right here, we'll say links and buttons. Like this one, for calls, it only allows links, doesn't allow for buttons. So very simple, very easy to create and use. And a lot of people use them. It's just basically a shortcut that can take you to various spots that you want to know. Sometimes it helps in, here's a good one. If you are having to worry about traveling to go see this client, you can do the directions mileage, and it will tell you how much. So you can then figure out, especially too, if you're paying employees. Maybe you're paying their mileage to go visit a site or a customer. Here's an easy way. I'm using a link to be able to calculate that for you. So links are fairly simple, fairly easy to make, as you saw. And if you like this, check out our YouTube page for more helpful videos. Things like buttons, custom functions, how to set up various Zoho products. Or if you have questions and would like help with building various aspects in Zoho, check out our website, zcrmhelp.com. We thank you and have a great day.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.